I'm too excited to wait. I have to film this right now. I'm gonna film the intro to this vlog tomorrow. I have like 5 minutes I need to work out. Or else I'm gonna be working out till like 8 p.m. But I need to see what's in this box and I can't wait till tomorrow. Really quickly, the Balm had emailed me asking if I wanted to come to their virtual Zoom launch party for the new blushes. They sent me the PR box and some other stuff for the launch party and that is what we're opening. Okay, you're caught up. So let's see what's in it. This is what it looks like. What's this guy say? Hi, Teresa Hirado. We're so excited for you to join our It's a Date Zoom party. See you then and enjoy our new products. XO the Balm team. Okay, so let's see. What is all of this? Oh my goodness. Let me get situated. This is what I'm looking at right now. So we're gonna make cocktails on the Zoom launch party, so I'm really excited. So they had sent over the ingredients and then also obviously their new blushes. So sent over these three, which I guess, can I unwrap them before? I don't even know. I can always wrap them. Oh, they're so cute. They must have the cutest packaging. And this is also in the new green packaging. Open it like that. Ooh. I almost dropped it. Can you imagine if I dropped it before the Zoom call? I'd be the worst influencer ever. Okay, so here's one of the colors. I'm not gonna show you all of them just yet, but this is so pretty. So their new green packaging, before they had like a magnet or something, but since you can't recycle that, they have like a little tab here so you can open and close it, and then you can recycle this once you're done with it. It's really cool. I have the three colors. Right here. Oh, it's a coaster. Oh, that's so cute. They really thought this out. This is so adorable. This is like kind of the mailer, the save the date almost. And it talks about their new blushes, all their clean packaging works. Nice, what's in it? I did read their email that they had sent and they talked a little bit about it. So I guess we're gonna be doing some kind of like tea-based cocktail. So I need to like steep these ahead of time. We'll look at the email then after. Ooh, a mason jar filled with, am I not supposed to open it? Ooh, it smells really good. Like I don't even know. I don't know if I was supposed to open that. Oh, two, what are these? Are they like little sugar things? They kind of look like little roses. I wonder if they're made of sugar. I'm gonna ruin this all before I even make it there. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. That's so cute. And then, Hella Cocktail. This is made with aromatic bitters. It's non-alcoholic, so it's just like the spritzer. Bitters and soda, made with Genetian tincture. Ready to drink now or mix with your favorite spirit. So it's just like a mix-up. Gluten-free, vegan, It has notes of clove, allspice, bitterroot, and orange peel. Okay, so I'm gonna put this in the fridge then too, so we have that. Oh my God, I'm so excited, this is gonna be so cool. Guys, I am running extremely late. I swear I had everything planned out and then it just got a little bit late. So basically what I'm doing right now, I need to prep for this. There's just a couple things they want us to get ready. I also need to grab the box. Actually, I really do that. So let me grab the box. Right now we're about 13 minutes out. 13 minutes. I'm really gonna notice my posture in this video. Oh my God. Okay, I'll leave you over there. I hope that's a little better. Okay, so basically what I'm gonna do right now, I have to go into their email. It sent me an email and they told me to get some stuff ready. I think it was only like a couple things like hot water and like a glass or something because we're gonna be making cocktails and that's so cool. I never know also, I don't know if you guys are like this because I don't know what you use Zoom for other than like friends in school, but if you use it for other stuff like doctor's appointments or talking to like a professional, you know, people doing interviews and stuff, how early do you log on without it being, I guess, offensive? Like, I don't know the term, like rude, I guess is what I'm trying to say. I don't wanna be late, first off, but too early, I read that that's like kind of offensive, I don't know. Okay, so I need the PR box. I got that hot water for the hibiscus tea bags. I can steep one for a light red or two for a deep red. Do I steep it beforehand? I really hope not. Measuring spoon or a shot glass. Ice on the ready. And a big lemon, okay, okay. Lemon, lime, alcohol, let's go. We're gonna run in the kitchen. You're not coming with me because I don't have time. Lime, aren't we glad we got a lime at Trader Joe's the other day? We got a bunch of limes actually. Shot glass. And this is the only alcohol I have at the moment. Hopefully tea goes well with tequila. The lightest taste with the strongest alcohol. Can you see what I'm doing? 4 minutes. So I'm gonna be filming, obviously, me. I'm not gonna like film them because I don't know if they would care, but I'm not the asking type, so I don't even wanna like ask, and we're just gonna not do that. Let me just ready my table here. I hope I wasn't supposed to pre-steep the bags. Why am I so nervous, man? Are you ready? Are you ready, guys? Let me make sure I have you available. Nope, that's I'm gonna join a 58, I've decided. Do I have everything? Why do I feel like I don't have everything? Andrew Gizzy is the mixologist. That's awesome. I feel like that's like right in the camera, like I'm ready to drink. I'll pre-slice a lime just in case I cut a finger. I don't want that on the Zoom call. This is a really bad idea. My table is so slippery. I am gonna cut my finger. Ooh, this would have been embarrassing. On camera. On their camera. My camera, it's fine. A big slice of lime. We're gonna get a little slice of lime because my limes are little. I'm having to rip them apart with my hands. Okay, time to get on here, guys. You look okay? My hair's real frizzy, but that's just me. Enter a password. The camera died. I'm sure you guys knew. Just got out of the meeting. I wanted to give you guys a brief rundown of it. Oh my gosh, it was so fun and different. First off, the cocktails were absolutely amazing. Like I know they had said he was a mixologist, but I don't know why. I just thought it would be someone that worked there as well, that also kind of knew how to make drinks. But no, this is like a guy who, put it right here, his Instagram tag name. He was like in his like bar thing making the drink. It was like crazy. And it turned out so tasty. Like I'm surprised because I didn't bring any pineapple juice or like a sweet juice. So when he used like a sweet juice, I didn't have that. So I just put water shots in it. And you guys saw that. But it still turned out so good. I'm so surprised because I didn't really add too much sugar. I added like a tiny bit and tequila, so that's crazy. But this was like super cute. I added a ton of petals on the top. I tried to add the little saved one because when I added it, it sunk right to the bottom. But oh well, I guess maybe that's helping too. There's like a little bit of sugar just at the bottom because it dissolved, but it's so good. Oh, I need to fix this. Why is it doing this? But anyway, okay, so now for the meeting part of it. I am super socially awkward. I think I talk about this a lot. And so it was a huge step for me to try to do this because it was so outside my comfort zone. Like I would never agree to this, but I was like, you know what? I should just do it. Just try it. I don't know why I'm like this, but I feel like people might think I'm angry if I don't smile. Like I definitely do have a really crazy resting, you know, face. I have to like put on at least somewhat of a smile, but I started the meeting really smiling to the point where my face started twitching because I was like, now I can't like drop the smile because you know when you smile too heavily, if you drop the smile, you're not lowering it. It's just a complete drop and like it'll look like something's horribly wrong. You know, like they said something wrong or something. So that was awkward for me. I was like, oh God, I need to like reset my smile. Just have like normal smile. It's so stupid because like no one can really even see you anyway, which I also don't really know how to work Zoom. I don't Zoom with my friends or anything like that. And I didn't realize that you should turn your mic off like if you're not talking or else it like switches to you. Like the video feed, did not know that. So that was also something. Once I saw everyone that had their audio off, I'm like, oh, the audio off. I don't even know how many people were in there. Maybe like 10 to 13 maybe. But it was really, really fun. Like we did the cocktail first, obviously. And then she was talking a lot about the blushes, which are, I guess we're one of the first people to get these. So like that's really cool. We like swatched them together. But it's a date blushes and there's three different ones. I think I showed you a little bit of this yesterday, but she was like talking about these and I was like swatching them and thinking, oh, this is why they feel that way. Cause when I first swatched them, I was like, this feels like oddly soft. Like we're just like the best thing I've ever felt in terms of like a powder. And it has a whole bunch of oils in them, like really good oils for your skin to keep it hydrated. And I don't know about you, but right here, sometimes my skin does get a little dry, like more than like here and here. So the fact that this has like an oil in it, I'm not wearing it right now, I should preface that. But the fact that this has like a lot of grapeseed oil, jojoba oil, a whole bunch of stuff, like that is amazing because that is gonna make sure that you don't have a lot of dryness here. There's also a couple ingredients that help with like acne. So it's just a little extra stuff that is really good for your skin. So I was like, ooh, like y'all's gonna love this. 100% recyclable too, showing us like you pop out the little pan. So like I said, this is a cardboard opening, so it's no more a magnet. And they also don't have like a mirror in here because obviously like that, you can't recycle. There's like a little hole right here. So once you finish this, you can just pop that out because the pan is metal, and then you can just throw that away, but then everything else can be recycled. So that is awesome. Oh my God, it got worse somehow. I will say though, I missed me doing my introduction. So introductions freak me out. I also didn't really know what the introduction was because I guess I had missed that. So I guess people did show up a little early for the meeting and they had started talking about like their name, where they're from, and what their perfect date is, because that's the theme. It's like a date theme. I didn't know that they had said that. So they were going around and I was just kind of trying to listen to what everyone was saying. I got the gist of like that they were saying their name and where they're from and all that kind of stuff. But then came my turn. I'm like, okay, I got this. I got this. I always get nervous when it comes to that. I don't know why, but I missed filming it on this camera, dang it. So got everything else, but not that. But I did speak at that point. And then they were asking for like feedback and like ideas and all that kind of stuff. Like it was a really cool, like chill, like environment. But I feel, I mean, actually I'm like this in person too. I hate when you talk and someone else goes to talk, and then you know you're both like, wait, who should do the actual talking? Like, I don't know why, I just hate doing that. So with especially with like lag and Zoom, I was just like, I'm not gonna say anything, because the minute if I say something, my screen will pop up, but then if someone else starts to say something, their screen pops up. I know it's the tiniest little thing, but for me that is just the worst thing ever. So I didn't really say much during the meeting. Not everybody was speaking, but there are a couple of people that were speaking a lot. But I mentally always keep track if I'm the only one not speaking. If I'm not, then I'll say something just because I'm embarrassed. But overall, I think it went really, really good. They did an amazing job of hosting this like Zoom launch event. Like it's such a cool idea. And our host was super, super sweet and so nice and so like personable. And yeah, I just had a really fun time. I need to fix my hair now. I'm not doing anything, but it's just gonna bother me. Dang. It's like I like stuck my hand in a socket. Look at it. There's my drink. I actually don't drink. Ooh, that is bitter. These are definitely made for like being a spritzer because I wouldn't drink these alone, but in this, perfect. Oh, I want to do more of those. Those are really cool. I didn't cut myself on my lime either. We're back. So that day was definitely very busy. I had so much fun though. I would love to go to more of those. I hope more brands like do more of like the Zoom stuff or just like live events. I feel like that might be a little bit more in tune with my personality, as in I will not have to worry about even talking. I actually really liked the fact that it was so personal. We got to like kind of like talk to them about like how we got to talk about what shades we might want for an extension of this line. But anyway, I wanted to show you like the actual swatches and put it on my face because I did not do that. We kind of just talked about the event, which is really fun. But I want to show you these blushes because they're really nice. We are in a very opposition right now, if you haven't noticed. I'm getting ready to film an Amazon Halloween costume try-on haul, so I have the whole room set up to like film that. So I wanted to do this beforehand because I'm not wearing any face makeup, and I want to show you three swatches of cheek stuff. I felt like that would be the easiest because I had to redo my makeup like three times. And these are like meant to be able to be used on natural skin if you want to also. So these are the three shades. I don't know if I showed you these up close, but Third Date, It's a Date, and then Big Date on the end here. So now this one is a much more shimmery pink. This is more of a coral, and this is like a darker kind of berry. Let's swatch them right here. And you can see this one is Third Date, this one's It's a Date, and then this one is Big Date. Immediately looking at them, I definitely think my favorite is gonna be the coral one, but it really depends because that one is a matte, whereas in the first one is a nice shimmery, and the last one's also like a matte. I do like a shimmery blush. I don't know if you guys know that about me, but I have three clean brushes. Where did I get three clean brushes from? Let's start off with the one I think I'm gonna like, which is the It's a Date one. This is the coral one. So I'm just gonna like pat it on here. And like I said, these have like a ton of really nice face oils. You just go on and they blend out so smoothly. That's like when I first tried it, I was so surprised. Like this feels different than a lot of my blushes. And also just to keep in mind, I'm not wearing face makeup, so it might look like patchy. That's just my skin. This one's cute. This one is definitely a buildable because when I first put it on, it was super subtle. I like mine a little bit more like not subtle. Ooh, okay, so can you guys see that? It's a nice just subtle like orange hue. It's not really an orange, more like a coral, but like a pink orange. It just kind of looks like warming. It's exactly the shade that I love. I could even probably go more if I wanted to because I like it a little darker. That's nice. That's my favorite, I think. Oh, okay, I haven't tried the others, but that one is really nice. Even though it's matte, I'm still really liking that. I just hope you can see it. I'm kind of in shadow. Now, I'm gonna wipe this off. Yeah, it was smart. No face makeup prior. I have a question for you guys. Write it down below because I'm actually genuinely curious because it was coming up in the meeting. Where do you guys put blush on? Like, do you put it just on your cheeks? Do you put it on your forehead, your nose? I know that's like been a huge thing about, like I've seen it on TikTok at least, where they put it on their nose and it looks really cute on some people for sure. On me, I think it makes me look like I have a cold. So literally the only place I put it is right on my cheeks. I may be like the minority in that, like other people might use it everywhere, but I don't. This one's Third Date, so this is like the pink shimmery color. And I've seen other people that will put it on their forehead. Again, that just makes me look sick flushed, not cute flushed. So I don't do that either. I feel like sometimes when you put it on bare skin, it's a little hard to see right away. Whereas if you start with foundation, it has something to grip onto. So also keep that in mind, but a little pinky. It's definitely a more pigmented shade, I would say, than the other one. I think this is really pretty too. I don't know now what I like better. Last but not least is the darkest one. Did I show you what the other one looked like in the pan? This was the orange color. Orange is coral. I don't know why. They're not synonymous. This is like the pinky sparkly one, so. Date is the darkest one. I would say this one is the most pigmented the quickest. Like, I only like added a couple little swipes and it's already like boom. But it's definitely like a darker, like a mauve-y almost. That's probably where I would stop with that one for myself personally. This one would be really cute for winter for sure. This is more of like, I would say like a cold weather kind of color. I would wear the others like anytime during the year, but I feel like those are a little bit more kind of warmish colors. So really just depending, I guess, on what you're wearing, but I'll do a little bit more. I can't tell if I can see it in the camera for you guys. Bomb's gonna watch this video and be like, what is she doing? There's that one. These are all freaking cute. I love them and I just love the formula. But I don't even know if I showed you up close. This is what I mean by the little green packaging. So see how this little tab, I can pull this out. And that's how you open it. And so to close it, you'll like put the tab back in. So it's a nice green initiative, you know, it's nice to have like a brand that, you know, has so many products and they do come out with so many different products to really take this kind of step, especially with like a blush. I know it's amazing to have like a mirror in there and so you can just like, I always say that, I like to have a mirror in the product, but at the same time, I totally understand what they were saying in the meeting. It's like, how many of these, you know, products do you have? And then what happens when you're finished with them? How many mirrors get thrown out? And I'm like, oh god, that is a lot of mirrors actually when you think about it. But yeah, I'm really excited about these blushes. They're so nice. I hope you guys like seeing them. I think I'm gonna end this vlog here because I think it's been a little bit long and I have to get to filming my Amazon Halloween outfits because I didn't realize it's freaking, what is today? It's the 20th. I need to get this video out like yesterday because it's gonna be almost Halloween. I'm gonna preface it in this video too because I don't want anyone to get the wrong idea, but the reason I'm doing this video is because I was just like, why should we give up Halloween content just because, you know, we can't really go out and have parties, we can't like visit people, all that kind of stuff. But I feel like there still should be some Halloween content that people like to watch it, people like to see, just like you can dress up a Halloween in your own house, you know, so I just thought that would be really fun. I'm gonna go. I have to finish my face makeup for the video, so I will see you guys in my next vlog. Thank you so much for watching, and I said that out of order. But I will see you in my next vlog. Bye.